Hello, hello everyone. I hope that you're having a great day. So before we proceed to our discussion, let's have first an exercise. So here we have an image. So what I want you to do is to describe the image, simple as that. So here we have image 1. Describe the image. So the boy is playing soccer in the park. So I will ask some questions. First, who is playing in the park? Obviously, that's the boy. Next, what is the boy doing? So the boy was playing soccer. Lastly, where was the boy playing soccer? In the park, of course. So next, we have an image 2. Kindly describe what is in the image. So the girl is walking upstairs. Now let me give you a question. Who is walking upstairs? Obviously that's a girl. Next, where is the girl heading? Of course, it's upstairs. So those exercises are actually related to our topic and you will find out how it is connected to our topic. So now let's proceed to our discussion. Adverbs of place versus preposition. So here's our objective. First, know on what is adverbs of place and preposition. Second, identify the various adverbs of place and preposition. And then third, distinguish the difference between adverbs of place and preposition. Adverbs of place. What is an adverbs of place? A type of adverb that refers to a location or to a combination of location and relation to that location. Adverbs of place tell us where things happen. They change or add meaning to a sentence. How do you use adverb of place? An adverb of place is always used to talk about the location where the action of the verb is being carried out. Adverbs of place are normally placed after a sentence object or main verb. So always remember that adverbs of place are normally placed after a sentence object or main verb. Many adverbs of place indicate movement in a particular direction and end in the letters ward or wards. Adverbs of place can be directional, indicate distance, or can indicate an object's position in relation to another object. So here's an example of adverbs of place as directional. So we have up, down, and around. So the kite is up there. Down for down, the shop is down the road. And around, they looked around the park. So, as what I've stated earlier, that an adverb of place are normally placed after a sentence object or main verb. So, our main object here for the kite is up there is the kite. So, it was indicating the distance, indicating the direction of the kite. So the shop is down the road. So the shop here is our object, and then it is indicating the downward is indicating the direction of the shop. So lastly, they looked around the park. So here we have adverbs of place referring to distance. So we have nearby and far away. So an example of nearby is the beach is nearby. So our object here is the beach and our adverbs of place is nearby. So another example is she lives far away. So here another is an adverbs of place typically end in the suffix wards. So we have forwards and downwards. So she's walking forwards. The elevator is going downwards. So our object here is she, And our our adverbs of place is forwards. And then the elevator is going downwards. So our object here is the elevator, and our adverbs of place here is downwards, which is referring to a distance. So let's continue to preposition. What is preposition? A preposition is a word or group of words used before a noun, pronoun, or noun phrase to show direction, time, place, location, spatial relationships, or to introduce an object. Here we have preposition of direction. So she drove to the store. So the preposition here is to, and then the store is the object of the preposition, not the direct object of the verb drove. So the to the store is a what we call prepositional phrase. We have another example for in or into. Don't ring the bell. Come right into the house, or come right in the house. Onto or on. Drive onto the grass and park the car there, or drive on the grass and park the car there. Some English speakers usually face confusion in using prepositions like in and on. So we use the word in when we talk about a situation in which something is enclosed by something else. On the other hand, on is used to talk about a situation when the object is placed above or outside something else. Get it? So you have the preposition of time. Preposition of time is a preposition that allows you to discuss a specific time period, such as date on the calendar, one of the days of the week, or the actual time something takes place. Here is an example. She was born in 1996. An example of at in sentence, he eats lunch at noon. Then on, he does laundry on Wednesday. So we have the preposition of place. So it is a preposition which is used to refer to a place or space where something or someone is located. Here is an example of preposition of place. So in, they will meet in the lunchroom. At, she was waiting at the corner. On, he left his phone on the bed. Some verbs and adjectives are followed by a certain preposition. Sometimes verbs and adjectives can be followed by different prepositions, giving the phrase different meanings, such as the children smiled at her. So our verb here is smiled, and our preposition here is at. So he is concentrating on his work. I helped to contribute to the previous research. Next, we have the difference between adverbs of place and preposition. So, for adverbs of place, in traditional grammar description, an adverb of place indicates movement in a general direction. For preposition, a preposition for place indicates movement towards an object. So, adverbs of place, adverb of place answers the question where to the verb. So verb plus where equals adverb of place. And then for preposition, a preposition on the other hand contains two or more words that tell something about either a noun or a verb. So lastly, for adverbs of place, there will be no noun or pronoun after an adverb. The example for this is the doctor is out. And then lastly, for preposition, there is always a noun or a pronoun after a preposition, such as she is out, which is a preposition, and of our sight is our noun. Alright, so we have next our short quiz, which will be answered by our viewer in 10 minutes, 8 to 10 minutes. after answering the questions, you can check your answers if you're correct or wrong. And then that's all. Thank you for listening. Hope you have a great day. Thank you.